Steve Madden strikes again. Hey sugar, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I'm Ro the Black Magnolia, your favorite bougie babe, bringing you all your bougie but budget-friendly tips and faves, and a little bit of everything in between. I've got some fabulous finds for you today. So let's dive right in and get into what the girlies are putting on their perfectly pedicured toes this summer season. I don't play about my footwear. I have got too many summers ahead of me and too many behind me to wear either ugly or uncomfortable shoes. Absolutely not. So finding the perfect pair is of the utmost importance to me, and finding them at an affordable price, that's the next most important thing. And that's why I love a good designer-inspired pair of shoes. And this video is chock full of them. The first category is sandals or flip-flops. We are gonna start off with the Kate Spade Jaylee Jelly Sandals. Floral appliques, floral patterns, floral bouquets, floral. Floral is the F word of the summer season in 2024. You are gonna find floral appliques, floral patterns, designs, all over everything in fashion this season, and shoes are no exception to that rule. So these Kate Spade Jaylee Jelly Sandals are perfect. It's like the grown-up version of the jelly sandals that we wore when we were kids, the kind that kind of, if it got too hot outside, would stick to your feet because they'd melt a little bit, those. But these are the grown-up version, and they're about $98. I think they're a fun addition for like a vacation sandal, or just if I'm wearing something really simple, just putting these shoes with them. $98 is more than I want to spend on a trendy shoe. So I found this alternative, and these are the Jeffrey Campbell Florally Slide Sandals. I love these, not just because these are a beautiful, less expensive alternative to the Jaylee sandal, but because my grandmother's name was Floralee, and I love that these sandals are named the same, but they are also about half the cost of the Kate Spade sandals. They are on sale right now. I think I found them on some sites for about $25, but they're usually about $45 to $48.99, and they're lovely. They've got that floral applique on them, not as much as that Jaylee sandal, but what I do really like about the Floralee sandal is that square toe. The square toe is really in vogue in sandals right now. You're gonna see that across a lot of designers this season. Neither of these come in half sizes, so if you have a wider foot, I would definitely say size up if you're gonna buy this type of sandal. It's gonna squeeze your foot if not. And the last caveat that I would have with these shoes is if this trend doesn't fit your design aesthetic, like if you're not a super minimalist kind of a dresser where these shoes are gonna get to be the star of the show, or unless you're taking them on vacation, I would say skip this one because they're really hard to layer into a current wardrobe if this isn't the way that your style already leans. I'd say for the price, definitely something that you could give a try, but not something that you're probably gonna get a whole lot of cost per wear out of. But they're a fun summer sandal either way. Who doesn't love a good casual shoe? Every wardrobe needs to have something like this in it. Sometimes the toes just need to be out. Now, I have struggled with the toes out for a lot of my life, but I have grown to love sandals and flip-flops and slides, and I think that they are a welcome addition to every wardrobe. And these next two that I have for you are both from Loro. Loro is the design house of Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen, and it has become synonymous with the quiet luxury, stealth wealth aesthetic. And their city leather calfskin flip-flops are just that. These come in at $890, and they've been all over the runway. Celebrities are also wearing these flip-flops on the red carpet in full glam. That's kind of a thing I guess people are doing now, is full glam or really elegant outfits with comfortable flip-flops. One of my very favorite style icons, Brooke Shields, actually wore this really beautiful yellow gown, and she paired it with some yellow Crocs. And she's actually a really funny, quirky kind of a personality, and I really thought that it fit and it worked. I feel like that's kind of what people are trying to do with these flip-flops, and the vibe that they're trying to give is that casual, basic elegance and comfort, because carrying an extra pair of shoes in your purse isn't always something that you can do when you're out and you're all dressed up. So making that extra pair of shoes, the actual pair of shoes that you're wearing with your outfit, is the aesthetic people are doing now. These flip-flops are $890. The strap and the sole are both leather on these. They're beautiful. I think that they're lovely sandals, but I found this alternative on Amazon for $44.99, and I love them. First of all, look at the packaging. The brand is Peori, and I absolutely adore these. These are leather, and they are so similar to the Rose sandal. Now, where the difference is that you're gonna find is the bottom of the Rose sandal is ridged and really ribbed, and it's kind of a thicker sole, so you are gonna get a little bit more height out of those. This doesn't have that, but if you look at the top, it is almost exactly that same shape. And what I love about this is that it doesn't have that toe piece that most thongs have that could just kind of pop out and ruin your whole day if the shoe breaks. And it's gonna be more comfortable as it's not gonna rub on your toe like a typical thong would. I love that about these. These are extremely padded and really comfortable, and they're just a really well-made shoe. I haven't really worn them out yet. I've tried them on. So far, so good, but for $44.99 as opposed to $890, I would definitely say yes to giving these a try. And then if you really do like this shoe and you wanna go ahead and get the actual designer version over on the row and spend that $895, go for it. The next pair of flip-flops are actually also from the row, where the calfskin leather is more of the high-end, upscale, wear it with a glamorous gown. This one is just a true flip-flop. It has a leather sole, but a rubber strap, and they come in at $650. And I don't think that there's any universe in the Matrix where I would feel comfortable spending $650 on a rubber strap flip-flop. I don't care how leather the sole is. I just, no. No man. Now the designer inspired alternative for these are a pair at Madewell. These are the Sleepers tapered sandal, and these come in at $39. The whole thing is rubber though. There's no leather on this one, but that's okay because it's the shape that we're going for. Remember, that is always what I preach when I talk about designer inspired items. It's about the shape or the look or the spirit of the thing and not it being identical or being a look-alike. And the strap is what really gives it that look of the row sandal. And I love these, and I love the price on them. $39, you can't beat them. And if the look of the row is what you're going for, that kind of understated luxury, this is gonna get it for you, and it's gonna do it for you at like a fraction of the cost. So I would definitely say if you like the look of the row, either the city flip-flop or the beach flip-flop, give these Sleepers tapered sandal a try. And now we're gonna get into the kitten heel category. I think that they're the easiest style shoe to either dress up or dress down and not feel like you're doing too much. And I mean, I always feel like I'm doing too much when it comes to fashion. That's just who I am. But these shoes make it so you can style any outfit super easily. Jeans, skirts, midi dresses, everything in a really easy way that still allows you to be super comfortable. And this Jimmy Choo silver liquid metal pointed toe kitten heel, say that five times fast, is divine, and I need them in my life. These come in at $950, and while the color and the whole kitten heel thing is a trend, I feel like this is more of a timeless trend that is on trend, but not trendy. If you've watched any of my other videos, you know that's something that I preach, is it can be on trend, but it doesn't have to be trendy. And if it's a timeless neutral color, I don't think you can go wrong. Now, $950 is not in the budget for everybody. We all know that Amazon and the Amazon sellers have got Jimmy Choo on lock when it comes to these designer-inspired shoes. Look at this. Do you see this? I know you're seeing this. I saw this and I said, ship it. And I'm waiting for them to come. This pair is $49.99. It comes with Prime and has 4.4 stars. It looks almost identical to the Jimmy Choo silver liquid metal shoe. And I think it would be great with denim. I think it would be great with anything white or beige or black. I think that these shoes are just the perfect, like, on-trend neutral that you could pair with just about anything in your wardrobe. It's a really comfortable heel height. It's on-trend. It's a nice neutral. There's nothing to hate about this shoe except for the $950 price tag. And if you can get this pair on Amazon for $49.95, they are a match made in shoe heaven. Next up, I have another pair from the row for you. This is the row combo kitten heel. Gorgeous. These shoes are extremely simple, understated, just like we know the row is. It's got this really interesting heel on it. It is a good height. These are gonna be comfortable shoes that you could probably walk around in all day whenever you're doing whatever wonderful things you're doing this summer, because you should be out doing some wonderful things this summer. You deserve it. These shoes are $920, and at $920, you're probably gonna have to sit in the house for a while and not go anywhere until you pay off the shoes or until you like replenish your savings account from buying these shoes. So I feel like finding a designer inspired version of them, or at least one that's close enough to the shoe, was a goal of mine, and I achieved it. Check these out. These are on Amazon for $49.89. Now the heel is slightly different, but that's okay. The shape of the shoe is what we're going for, not a look-alike. We are going for an inspired version, and I really feel like that this gives that. I like a shoe that I feel like I could put with just about anything in my wardrobe and not feel like I have to completely change my style in order to love them and have them. Having my cake and eating it too, stylistically, is something that is extremely important to me when it comes to my shoes. being comfortable, being beautiful, and being versatile. Those are the three things that I need all of my shoes to be. Now, sometimes I'm just gonna buy something because they're beautiful and I want them. It could be sky high Louboutins. I think a lot of us have a pair of those in our closet, but they're not real practical. I don't want every pair of shoes in my closet to be shoes that I can walk to the door in and then have to immediately sit down in. And that's where I'm finding this new trend of all of these kitten heels coming back in to be something that I absolutely love. And I can wear these and walk around and not feel like I need to bring an extra pair of shoes or slippers in my bag with me. And at $49.89, I cannot say no to them. And I have so many different ways that I want to style a shoe, and I can't wait for them to come in. Have you ever just seen a pair of shoes and gone, I need you? These are the shoes that I'll be buried in. These are the ones. I want these on my feet all the time. Now that might sound a little bit ludicrous, a little bit far-fetched, but you know what I'm saying. There's just some shoes that you absolutely fall in love with, and these Prada satin mules were that pair for me. Look at these shoes. They are gorgeous. And for $1,120, they better be. These shoes better pat me on the tush and tell me I'm pretty every time I put them on. Like I said earlier in the video, that square toe box is on trend for summer 2024 when it comes to shoes. And this Prada mule is giving all of that. Stylistically, this heel is so avant-garde and really artistic. I love that about this shoe. And I love this rich tobacco chocolate color that it comes in. It's beautiful. And I really wanted to give this shoe a try before I even contemplated committing to $1,100 in shoes. So I found this pair on Amazon. It is $52.99. No reviews, but almost identical. There's no branding, nothing like that on these shoes, but the shape is identical. And they come in that tobacco color and in black, and I love them. And I think that I definitely want to give these a try. I'm still kind of on the fence because sometimes when the pictures look this good online, you kind of wonder, are these going to be a scam? I don't want to get scammed. I'm hoping these shoes are not a scam. But they do come with Prime, and as of the filming of this video, there is a 5% off coupon on them. So, I mean, I think I'm gonna give them a try. Let me know in the comments down below if you think I should give these shoes a try, if you're gonna give them a try with me, and let's see what happens and compare notes once they get here. And if you haven't already, sugar, make sure that you head on down to that subscribe button. Click it, turn on your notification bell, and make sure that you never ever miss any of the videos that I have here for you, because I enjoy this. I enjoy us, and I hope you do too. And another style that's really on trend right now is that knife edge or that super pointy toe on all of these kitten heels. And this Vernice Saffiano leather shoe, Prada has me in my feelings right now. Not just because the shoes are beautiful, but because they're also so stinking expensive. These are $1,200, but they are gorgeous. So I did like I always do, and I went on Amazon and I found a pair that look extremely close. They are $59.99. There are no reviews, but they are absolutely beautiful. Something I talked about in one of my other videos is that if I find an item that I love and there's no reviews and I don't really know a whole lot about the seller, I'll check their store to see if they've got other items that have some good reviews, or if the item that they're selling that I'm looking at is just kind of a one-off and something that they saw was trendy. I did go to their store and they do sell a lot of other shoes. None of them had any reviews on them, but I thought, oh, I'd give them a try because shoes are kind of their thing. There is no branding on the shoe, but it does have that same shape Prada emblem, but there's no branding on it. So I thought, let me give it a shot and see what happens. I'll let you know how they are when they come. And these might be a pair that you want to try as well, but I do love the Vernice Saffiano leather shoe from Prada, and I think that this is a really great alternative. And our next category is flats. You know who's back in the game? Yes, Mary Jane, she is back in the game. She never really left for me. I always love a really good Mary Jane. I grew up wearing them. I tried a pair that Loewe had a while back. I didn't love them, they were a little bit too chunky. I love the kind of in-between mix of a ballet flat and a Mary Jane, and that's what these next pairs are. Now, Le Monde has their velvet Mary Jane. These shoes are adorable. They're $495, they're beautiful. I love that velvety, buttery look to them. $495 isn't what I want to spend on a pair of Mary Janes. As an alternative, Sam Edelman has a pair for $130. These are really pretty. I love this color on them. They're beautiful. I love the buckle. Really well done. And the bonus is that you can get this pair of Sam Edelman shoes on Amazon on a try before you buy. I thought that was a really great option because $130 isn't $495, but it's still not nothing. So you can give them a shot on that try before you buy option and see if you really want them. Now, me personally, while I do love these Mary Janes and I love both the LeMond and the Sam Edelman, I like a little bit skinnier of a strap. I don't like it as wide. The brand Margot has their Mary Jane for $129. They're running out of pairs. This velvety green color that they have though just has me in a chokehold. I love a jewel tone colored shoe. It could be like the ugliest shoe on the planet, but you put it in the right color and I'm gonna be all over it. Not really, but you get what I mean. I do love all of these jewel tones in these Mary Janes. So it's not just your basic black, it's all of these different fun colors that they come in. So I wasn't able to find anything that was similar to the Margot on Amazon or on any other sites that was a little bit more affordable, but I did find one that was close to the Sam Edelman version on Amazon for $74.79. The buckle on the strap is a close match to the Sam Edelman. Colors aren't the same. This is a brown, kind of a chocolatey color. I didn't see any of the colors that kind of matched that really pretty mauvey pink, but this brown is actually a really cool color as well. It's a great neutral and something that you could pair with a lot of different outfits. It's a really great option to give this trend a try to see if it's something that you want to step back into or something that you want to try for the first time. At $74, it is a more expensive designer inspired shoe, but at that more expensive price point, I am expecting better quality, and we'll see once it gets here. And last but not least, I could not do a designer inspired video and not include Loro Piana, one of my absolute favorite designers. This is their Babouche Charms Walk Slip-On Moccasin. This is a variation of their classic moccasin that they have, and I love this shoe. They are $1,275. It's Loro Piana. We know they're just gonna be expensive, but guess what? Steve Madden strikes again. I got my eldest daughter a gift card to Steve Madden for Mother's Day, and we were wandering around the mall, and I said, let's go to Steve Madden, use your gift card, let's get some shoes. And I just so happened to wander towards the back of the store, and I found these. And this is the Lakeside Tan Suede shoe. And when you see these, you'll know exactly what I mean by Steve Madden strikes again. Do you see what's happening here? Do you see what's happening here? Aside from the little like red charm in the center of the Loro Piana shoe, this, tell me where this is different. Tell me where this is different. These shoes are so comfortable. The fit is fantastic. If you have a wider foot, this is definitely a shoe that you're gonna love because it is not snug in the toe box in here at all. These are gorgeous. So these are $59.95 on the Steve Madden website. If you've never shopped on their site before, there is a 20% off coupon. In store right now, these shoes are an extra 60% off. I got these just over $25. Yes, I said it and I'll say it again. I got these for just over $25. I don't even know what to say. And I'm telling you, if you love that Loro Piana Babouche moccasin, go and get these Lakeside moccasins from Steve Madden. Even if you get them online and you get them at just that 20% off, come on, like, just do it. And if you've already shopped with Steve Madden online before, go into your local store. They may actually have them and you can get them for that 60% off. I don't have words for how happy it made me. I wanted these in a 9.5. They didn't have them, so I did size up half a size to a 10, and it worked. It doesn't feel like it's gonna slide off my foot, so that's definitely something that you can do. And it comes in two colors, a chestnut brown and this tan suede. I didn't love the chestnut brown so much, but this tan suede is like identical to the Loro Piana color. And so I really wanted to make sure I got these and added them to my collection. I feel like this is gonna be a great transitional shoe between summer and fall. We have to start thinking about that coming up here pretty soon because it's something that I'll still be able to wear when it starts to get a little bit colder here. Now, we all know in California, anything under 75 degrees is cold. So yes, I am starting to get more forward thinking about chillier weather. But in the meantime, I think that I can wear these with just about anything. I love this shoe. I love that it's a nice neutral color. I love how comfortable it is. And it is a welcome addition to my shoe collection, and it is going to carry me through many of the summers that I have ahead of me to wear. And that is it for the video, sugar. Let me know in the comments below which is your favorite pair. I think I did a pretty good job of finding a wide variety of shoes that you can add to your collection, whether you want the actual designer version or the designer-inspired version. I think that all of these options are incredible. And if you are starting to build your shoe collection, I think that there are great options to get you started in here as well. So, if you found something that you love, if you had a good time, if you enjoyed hanging out with me, make sure that you subscribe, make sure that you liked the video, and that you share it with somebody who needs some more designer-inspired shoes in their life. And I will see you in the next video.